Good morning, watch nerds. I'll start off by telling you, this watch is no longer available. However, if you're like me, you buy most of your watches used, and you want to watch some reviews on them. Now, as a matter of interest, there is only one other proper review of this watch on YouTube, so you may want to put up with me for the next 10 minutes. To fund this watch, I sold my Mitch Mason Chronicle, which may I add, is one of the best quality watches I've ever laid my hands on. Not only was the fit and finish perfect, the specification was also very high. Unfortunately though, we fell out of love and I needed another watch in my life to fill an empty slot in the watch box. I hunted high and low, but struggled to find anything I really liked, until this one came along. Believe it or not, this watch is about 6 years old, but it's had very little wear and thus in excellent condition, almost mint. Of course, it wasn't free, and to be honest, wasn't particularly cheap considering its age. I ended up negotiating a price of £300 for a watch that was only £400 when it was new. But as they so rarely come up, especially in this condition, I just didn't want to miss out. Steinhart, I'm sure you know, are a German company, although their watches are produced in Switzerland. Of course, like many Swiss branded watches, I'm sure many of the parts are made in China. But that doesn't bother me because I know the Chinese have some engineering techniques and machinery that can't be matched anywhere else in the world. Sorry, but that's true. I have owned several Steinhart watches over the years, starting with the Vintage Red. This was a 42mm homage to a vintage watch made by a famous company that begins with R. It was a cracking watch. But not long after, I decided 42mm, well, it was just too large for my puny 17cm wrist. I then purchased a few 39mm Steiners, which I very much enjoyed for a while. Steiner, of course, are famed for their high quality homages, always using Swiss movements such as Solita and Etta. Unfortunately, I always found the cases a little bit flat, as well as always being fully polished. This watch, however, is not a direct homage to anything, and the case is different to any other Steiner I've ever seen or owned. In fact, the watch design is loosely based on a nautical watch worn hundreds of years ago. Anyway, enough of this waffle, and on with the review. And welcome to my unpaid and unsponsored review of the Steinhart Marine 38. As usual, I'm going to start off with the dimensions. Now, regardless of what the manufacturers say, this is what I measured. The case is 38mm, the lug width is 20mm, the depth is 12.8mm, and the lug to lug is 46mm. On a leather strap, it weighs about 76 grams. These are a great set of dimensions, as this watch will probably fit a wrist from about 6 inches right through to 8 inches. That said, because of the colour and the dial layout, it does wear a little bit larger than the dimensions indicate. The watch arrived in the normal Steinhart packaging and box. It's quite premium, but not fantastically so. Inside, there's a tag which obviously was attached to the watch. There would also have been a 2-year warranty card, but needless to say, that's now expired. And this is my watch of the day. It's the second hour mandala. And isn't Amy looking lovely? Now, it's powered by the ETA 2824-2 Hellebore grade, which means it's been regulated in several positions. These movements generally have a 10-year service interval, but as this has hardly been worn, I'd expect that period to be longer than that. It ticks away at 28,800 beats per hour, has 25 jewels, hex, hand winds, and it's got a 38 hour power reserve. These movements are known for their accuracy and reliability, and have been used in luxury watches costing an awful lot more than this one. When this arrived, it was running about 15 seconds slow a day though. This movement is very easy to regulate, so I had the back off. Now let's see what the time grapher thinks of it. There we are, quite healthy, a very good amplitude, plus 1 second a day, and a beat error of 0.5. which is acceptable but not brilliant. I would describe the crown as being a sort of semi-onion design. It measures 6mm, it's push-pull, and instead of signing it, the end is blue. I'm still not sure if I like that or not, but it's unusual, and I do like unusual. Now the knurling is quite reasonable, although not incredible, and it's very easy to use. Operation and movement is extremely smooth. Oh, as a matter of interest, the claim water resistance is 50 metres. That means if you forget to take it off when you get in the shower, it's only a strap that you're going to ruin. I don't honestly see anyone taking this in the water though. Well, not intentionally. It was the dial that drew me to this watch. The Arabic numerals are pushed right out to the sides, although there is a minute track squeezed between them and the inside of the case. A date window at the 6 o'clock, and an applied logo at the 12. I'm not sure if Steinhart would have been better off with a painted logo, or on this occasion, at least a black applied one. The spade hands are blued, but I don't think this is done by using heat. Anyway, they look very nice nonetheless. Now I'm not sure if the dial is made of enamel or some sort of ceramic, and after some research, I still don't know. Regardless of what it's made of, it's very eye-catching and nice to have in my collection. I must say, I've always loved the Steinhart branding, and the Chinese, who may I add, make some fantastic watches, should learn by this. Simply pick up a German dictionary and choose a word. It's that simple. As far as the loom goes, well, let's have a look at it. Yep, you're right, it doesn't have one. But does that bother me? No, not much. It really isn't that type of watch, especially as the black indices are painted on. The case really is very nice, although I'm not convinced it could be a millimetre or so less deep. Now the fixed bezel is very nicely polished. The tops of the lugs have circular brushing, whilst the sides are satin brushed. Unlike Steinhart dive watches, which tend to be a little flat, this one's actually very nicely shaped. The case back screws down, and on the outside has some basic information engraved, whilst the centre is of the exhibition variety. It's worth noting that as well as the dome front crystal with the AR coating, Steinhart went to the expense of making the rear crystal sapphire as well. Of course, this isn't strictly necessary, but it's nice all the same. Moving on to the strap, well, it came on this brown crop print version. It's very well made, and it actually suits the watch very well. However, I prefer not to use the original one, because if I decide to sell the watch, it's going to make it easier to flip if it's in good condition. So I put it on this blue ostrich strap version. I did this because I believe it suits the blue hands very well. I also took the original butterfly clasp off of the original strap and put it on this one. Tell me what you think about it in the comments below. So in conclusion, I know it's very unlikely I'm ever going to bump into anybody else wearing one of these watches, and that gives me great pleasure. Now I'm presently going through a stage when I'm enjoying white and silver dials, so this pleases me as well. Although not new, this watch is in mint condition, and I believe £300 for a Swiss made watch with netter movement represents pretty good value. It may have been nice if it had a screw down crown, but I suppose it isn't necessary, and I suppose the same could be said for the lack of loom. Now other than those two things, and the fact I believe it could be a little bit less deep, I'm extremely pleased with my purchase, and I'd strongly recommend this watch to anybody in a position to pick one up. Now that brings me to the end of this review, so if you've enjoyed it, please click on the like button, subscribe if you haven't already, leave your comments below, and enjoy the rest of your day.